Today we're going to have a look at webauth.com and how to add a passkey. Now, passkeys are devices, secure devices that let you sign transactions and kind of like prove you are who you say you are. We're going to start off today with a Yubikey. This thing is basically like a key. It's a security key. And with this thing here, it allows you to sign a transaction anywhere in the world and verify that it's you. So if a hacker, for example, got onto your computer, they actually need to physically press this thing here in order to send some crypto. So we're going to go through, set that up, and see what it looks like. So let's dive in. So the first thing you want to do is visit webauth.com. This is essentially just like the mobile wallet, except it lives entirely in your browser. I'm actually going to open this in incognito mode. So we're going to start with webauth.com. We're going to visit webauth.com in the web browser, and then you should see a page like this. So this is it. This is the web wallet. All you need to do is click get started. And then if you haven't created an account yet or an XPI network account, click sign up. But in this case, I'm just going to log in with my existing WebAuth wallet on the mobile. So I'm going to click login. And then up here, it's either asking for our account name, if we've previously logged into webauth.com, or if you haven't, you're going to go to login with mobile or desktop wallet. And then, of course, right now I'm logging in with my mobile device, so I'm going to click mobile. I'm going to pull out my trusty iPhone, which you can see here. I'm all logged in and connected. This is where I created my account. On the mobile app, of course, I can sign transactions with either my PIN code or Face ID. And we pretty much want to give the web wallet or web browser version that same capability. So I'm going to click the scanning icon here. And then we are going to scan that QR code. Now, it is going to say blocks.io here when you log into webauth.com. You're going to click, you can see here what it's asking. It's asking for account information to access your avatar, whatever public information there is, and other permissions, make transaction requests, and view public transaction history. So this webauth.com can make a request, but of course you have to authorize it, right? Which we'll do here, use my Face ID. And as you can see here, we're logged in, which is great. All right, now that we're logged in, we want to go ahead and grab our YubiKey and stick it in the USB slot on our laptop. Now, these YubiKeys, they come in different flavors, USB-A, USB-C, but in this case, mine's a little bit more of an old school one. So I'm going to chuck it in the laptop here, and that's going to connect. So we've got five tabs down at the bottom of the wallet. We've got the home page, markets page, where you can swap accounts, profile page, and this key down here is our list of signing devices. Now, currently I've got one set up already. This is Windows Hello that's already set up, but I want to add my YubiKey, right? I want to be able to sign transactions with the key. So I'm simply going to click add new device and then select YubiKey. Go next. And then I want to select security key here. And now it's asking, hey, I want to set up my I want to set up your security key. The request comes from chrome.exe, right? Because we're in the web browser. So I'm going to click OK. And now it's asking me to simply touch my security key here, which I'm going to do. Done. Just like that. It's all set up. And I can name it. You can put this anything, but remember, this is public. So you might want to obfuscate it and be like stick or USB or something to that effect. But in this case, I'm just going to chuck UB for now. Now, here it's asking us to verify that we actually want to add another signing device. And we are going to do that in our wallet. Mobile wallet that's has just popped up. It's asking me to confirm the transaction, basically asking me to if I want to add this WebAuth signing device. And I'm going to click authorized, verify with my Face ID. Boom, just like that. Very cool. now what I want to do is actually make this my default signing device. So I'm going to click these two little, these three dots here, and I'm going to click set as default. I'm going to go to security key again, click next, and verify. Just like that, YubiKey is now the default. What that means is I can now put my phone away and go to the home screen, and now I want to send some crypto, right? So I'm going to send one XPR to this account. Now watch this. When I click send now, it's actually going to pop up and ask me for my security key. So I'm going to click next. Here it is. It's flashing. So I'm going to use my finger. Boom. Just like that. Instant. Done. This is really cool because basically what it means is you can take this stick, put it on your key ring, put it in a safe, put it in your wallet, somewhere that you're not going to lose it. And yeah, it doesn't matter which computer you're on, whether you're at an internet cafe and you need to move some funds like quickly. As long as you've got that and access to the internet, you're going to be able to send that crypto. Now, what happens if you lose this YubiKey? Well, hopefully, you've still got your mobile device where you can send crypto from there. But ultimately, you should always have your private key or mnemonic phrase, basically, which is 12 words, right? But in this case, I've backed up my private key, so if anything happens to my phone or my YubiKey, then I can still recover my funds, right? So, now I'm going to show you how to add a different signing device, or how to use one. So we're going to go to devices here, and in this case, I'm actually going to delete this other signing device here, this Windows device, and I click these three little dots and click delete. Should ask me for my security key. Boom. Verifying that it's me. Boom, gone. It's always a good idea once you've added a device, created a new default device, is to log out and log back in with that device key, because that's what it's now expecting, right? It's the default device. It's not expecting the mobile phone to sign here on the web. It's expecting the YubiKey. We're going to go ahead and add a new device, and this time is my Windows Hello. So we're going to log in, and it's going to grab my ID, just like that. Hello, Paul. Great. Click to confirm it's you. Passkey saved, which we love. And I'm just going to go Windows. So here I'm going to choose my security key because it was the default, or is currently the default signing device. So it needs for webauth.com. So I need to go ahead and select security key. And then of course, you got the flashing wire for Yubi. And just like that, we have added another signing device, which is Windows Hello. So what I can do is go here, sign out. See how effective this is. So we're on the home page. Let's go get started. Log in with Paul. Cool. So say now I want to set Windows as my default signing device. I can totally do that. Hello, Paul Gray. And now if I want to send 1XPR, it should now request my Face ID from YubiKey. I mean, from Microsoft. Boom. So there you have it. That's webauth.com. As you can see, I am, in fact, in an incognito browser, so you don't need to save any kind of cookies, or it doesn't matter if you clear your history or whatever. You can always sign in with either your YubiKey or Windows Hello signing device, or, of course, your mobile with Face ID. So there you have a quick intro guide to adding signing devices with webauth.com. If you are on a Apple device, like an Apple Mac, for example, or Mac OS, instead of Windows Hello, you're actually going to see Touch ID here. So you might have a Touch ID Mac with a fingerprint reader. it'll ask you, you know, to set it up, and you'll simply use your finger on the fingerprint reader. You can, of course, add Ethereum wallet, which is just like MetaMask or something like that, if you prefer to sign with that. And, of course, you can add other types of passkeys, right? So if you go like this, and hypothetically you wanted to add 1Pass signing key, or, you know, you can actually even sign here. If you go more choices, I can now scan this passkey with my mobile phone, and I'm going to save a passkey. Device connected. So say I want to save it on my Apple device. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Cool, passkey saved. I'm going to call this one Face ID. Add new device. Because Windows Hello is the default, it's going to use that to verify the transaction. And after this, I can now set that as default, which I should be able to use the passkey here. And again, go continue. Signed, it is the default. So what I can do is go ahead and send 1XPR again, but this time, instead of signing with my Yubikey, which I'll unplug, I can now sign with my Face ID. And of course, oops, to go to the camera, sign with a passkey, continue. That's me. So just like that, we have now added 3 signing devices. Now, that's probably all we need for now. And what I can do is actually demo this working in Safari on the mobile phone. So let's go to Safari, go to webauth.com. And here, if I click my key here, in fact, I'm gonna sign out just to reset everything. Log in with Paul. Here's my Face ID, my YubiKey. So let's go ahead and set Face ID as the default here. Boom. So I am in the web browser. You can see this is not the app itself. I can install the app on my phone, but you can actually essentially use the wallet, at least on XPR network, in the web. So again, I'm going to go send 1XPR. Just like this, sending. It's going to get my Face ID. Boom. So as you can see, incredible features on WebAuth.com. WebAuth.com was actually the first wallet to first crypto wallet to integrate passkeys like this. Well ahead of its time, I think 2 years ahead of most other crypto companies and things like that. So with the WebAuth wallet, we are just getting started. Expect many more updates. You may have noticed the web version, or the mobile version on your device, now actually supports Optimism mainnet and a number of other EVM chains. So yeah, come get stuck in, try it out, create your free at name. Remember, every single XPR network account has a at name, so you can create your very own custom name for free. And so instead of a long crazy wallet address, you just have this simple name, you know, I love money. Too easy. All right, guys, that's it. And I will see you online. If you want more of this content, like, follow, comment, all that good stuff. So, yeah, peace.